Okay, good afternoon everyone. So this is a simple illustration of the style that is attached to this video. So this is our basic ground block, and this is my bust point, my waist point, my hip, and then this is the length of the gown. Now, after measuring, this is my original measurement. This one over here is my original measurement. So I'm going to add extra allowance of maybe 2 to 3 inches. This the fabric is unfold, so I'm going to add extra inches on my original draft. Let me say 2 to 3 inches, depending on how full you want the gown to be. So after doing this, I'm going to stretch the shoulder length. I would originally measure the client from the tip of the neck to the wrist, wherever your client wants the sleeve to get to. So whatever it's the measurement you get from your neck point, you stretch down to wherever it falls, and this is termed the sleeve length. So going further now, from this hip point, you would make a curve that will connect down to the I'll connect down to the sleeve length. You just connect it down here. You don't need to bother about this circle sign here, because by the time you start sewing, you're going to realize that it's all going to get covered. Then at this point, at my waist point, I'll just move further down from the extra inches I inserted, and then create an opening on my draft. This is what I'm going to transfer to my fabric, and then I'll show you guys how I've cut it and then how I'm going to join it. Okay, so this is how after I've cut the fabric, this is how my draft looks. If you look closer, you find out that I've already inserted a small opening in the fabric, but when I'm sewing, I'm going to use my machine to create a bigger hole. I just put this so that I could know the exact spots. If you also notice, my whole cutting was not so much because I didn't have enough fabric, but you can have something that opens up further down on this end if you have enough fabric to spare. First thing I'm going to do after I've cut out my fabric into the pattern is to turn the neck inside out, okay, to finish it. And then I'm going to connect right side to right side of the fabric. I'm going to join the whole edges, the whole of the edges of the fabric. I'll just join it. Hey everyone, so the first thing I did was to turn the neck of my dress, and then also join all the edges round, and then I increase the size of my opening. So this is the dicey part. So what I will do is I will turn this on each other and then put a pin on it. So I've been able to turn it in with my and then pin them down. So you can just do a top stitch on this, or in order for it to look a bit nicer and neater, you just go in, and then you can go in first of all from the sleeve opening here, then you sew this portion, because you can't just turn it in and then sew round at once. You have to come through different opening. So you can come through first of all the sleeve opening here and then sew one part, then you can also then come through the neckline and sew this other portion, so that the fabric will not, so that it will be easy for it to just turn around, and then you still achieve this, because there's, you can go a particular way and then you're not able to turn the fabric and still get this opening that you have here. I sewed this portion now through the sleeve. I passed through the sleeve to sew it. So the next one, I'm going to go through the neckline to be able to get to this point. It just makes the work easier, Sha. So this is the outcome after joining the both openings. So the next thing I'm going to be doing is to create a curve here, like an opening, and then also turn it, and that's all. I'll show you the finished look soon. Okay, so this is the finished look of the gown, and this is the opening. Like, you can use a belt on it for more emphasis, whatever it is you want to use, and accessorizing it is just fine. So you can try yours and upload if you like.